here in the last 3 months, your image has become of this absolute public anti-national. Whatever may happen, your name has to drag in there in whatever conversation may happen on social media. So tell us, what is your coping mechanism when all this happens?
So the first thing I did was I deleted the Twitter app from my phone. I'm like, I don't constantly need to, check my phone on that. So I don't have the app. If I have to use Twitter, then I'll go on the computer, then I'll, make the effort of typing in. So I'm just so that it's limited how many times I check the hate. Other than that, about people, all of a sudden being this anti-national figure, first, I really don't understand the whole what is anti-national, because I feel like I feel like your actions are whether anti the nation or not anti the nation or are for the nation. So my thought process, the things that I have been endorsing are for the nation, which is non-violent campuses, peace on the borders, which is safer places for women. And these are things that we really need in this nation right now. These are conversations that really need to happen. I'll tell you what is actually anti the nation. Calling your own women, objectionable names, that is a very anti the nation act.
Do you think that women have a certain handicap when dealing with these trolls? And do you think that maybe the cyber crime cell can come in and help in such ways?
About trolling, you're right. I mean, with women, the trolling, it's not trolling. They're not hating on you. It's sexual abuse. It's sexual harassment with women. The first thing, if you want to shut a woman down, just defame her or, malign her character or just go in that direction. With men, you don't see that happening. With men, it's just jokes. And with men, of course, that's an harassment in itself. But with women, it's different.
The Indian Army, an institution to obviously, which you're obviously close to, lauded a man who has been accused of tying another human being to the front of a jeep. How do you feel? Do you feel that it's something that is fine and that these human rights violations are just an act of war?
I have to go with Lieutenant General Panag's viewpoint on it. I share the same opinion as him. And about the forces applauding the man, I feel maybe they're coming from a certain, a certain ideology, maybe they're coming from a certain viewpoint. It might be okay for them, and I think they have the right to think that.